ಶ್ರೀಮತಿಗೆ ನಾಮ ಉದಾಹರಣ is an institution as well as today is the most jubilant celebration of the ineffable status of our Indian scientific heritage. And as we are generally approaching everything in an analytical status, we have to say what do you call by Indian and what do you call here by heritage and what do you mean by scientific heritage. Everything that springs from civilization reaches the status of culture, and they are culminated, they are surmounted in the paramount peak of being called as a heritage. Civilization is the root for everything. Civilization is a mark of the psycho-intellectual maturity of beings. Both the mental maturity in which the person gains affinity, in which the person gains amicability, adjustability, tolerance, values of brotherhood, etc. The person bends and amends himself to be a socially fittest person to create an environment which can cater to the needs of all people, resulting in all around happiness and peace. So civilization is first not only physical dressing or agriculture or development of the social infrastructure, but it is the psychological maturity which also buds and blossoms into intellectual maturity. Intellectual maturity that deals with the potencies for exploration of the environmental conditions, factors and elements, and try to implement the same for the prosperity and productivity of all. So this is what we call civilization. Civilization is psycho-intellectual maturity. Then if the same thing, what is conceived, what is visualized and conceptualized, the same thing is being materialized and distributed, that becomes culture. Culture means practical civilization. The nobility and greatness of the civilization and its values, whenever they are made visible in different forms, art forms, behavioral forms, devotional structures, ethical treatises, in the form of anything, inscription, literature, way of living, and whatever we have as a record of either history or contemporary or futuristic view, that is known as culture. So practical civilization is what we call culture, and having a strong flow of the same culture impeccably, uninterruptedly, that is the preservation of the culture is known as heritage. So maturity of the status is known as civilization, practical benevolence of the civilization is culture, and preserved values of culture is what we call heritage. So now we are coming into the culmination or the saturation or the so-called sublime status of what we call as civilization. And everybody assembled here, they are all admirers of our great Indian knowledge system, the scientific heritage. We are all very much either chauvinistically or realistically attached to our own system and culture. So having a group of people who can nod their heads and clap their hands and to describe something about our national pride, certainly it will be an emotional distribution more than an intellectual debate. But still I want to see some of the flaws of these things and also the methodologies of rectification of those flaws, so that the real heritage, the perennial value and the turbulent and torrential charge of the value of the heritage can be brought out for real productivity and enhancing the status of India in the global scenario. There are innumerable civilization theories regarding India. There is early civilization theory, and second is great civilization theory. The third thing is unique civilization theory, member civilization theory. Innumerable theories are there. So what do we call by early civilization theory? It says that India had the earliest status of civilization, and this Sumerian civilization, Babylonian civilization, this Mesopotamian civilization, Incan civilization, Akkan civilization, all of the Mayan civilization, various these things, they just occurred after various centuries and millennia after Indian civilization. So it is a concept of earlier civilization of India, number one. Number two is mother civilization concept, in which they say that conversations between various people by means of contacts, collisions, clashes through invasion, migration, trade and various things, they have causated innumerable civilizations. But our civilization is a mother civilization, it is a parental body, from whom all civilizations they emerge. It is the concept of mother civilization theory. What is greater civilization theory? They accept that lot of civilizations they coexist, but Indian theory or the Indian system of knowledge or Indian civilization is greater. Fourth thing is unit. They say that innumerable system they are having on the basis of the land. The land describes their lenience. The lenience describes their propriety, their inclination, the mental setup that describes the linguistic, social, political, economical, and religious emergences. So each and every system has its own uniqueness, and India is also unique. That is known as unique civilization theory. And also one more theory is that it is a member civilization theory. That is, India is, or Indian civilization or Vedic civilization is one among the greatest or one among the greater civilizations of the world. So there are innumerable beliefs in the civilization theories which say that this theory is, our system theory is earlier, it is parental, it is unique, it is greater, and it is a member of various civilizations of the world. And there is one more theory which is known as Vishwaneta theory or Jagatguru theory, which is followed by most of the patriotic, Chauvinistic, realistic, dynamic and dogmatic membership of our citizenships. So they call Vishwaneta. So the administrative potency of the India, being the knowledge government or the knowledge ruler of the whole world, it need not be a physical invasion or a military intrusion or by a government of dominance by means of intrusive methodology. It is by means of a peaceful trade and by means of knowledge dissemination and spreading of culture. It is culture permeation through noblest means. So Vishwaneta and Jagatguru, this is the status given by most of the people here. And the problem is there is no repudiation in accepting this as Vishwaneta or Jagatguru. I have to do that as more varying the things, more I am permeated into that and more propagating the same thing. I have to just render it more with more vehemence and velocity more than what people are doing. But certainly, the tools that are taken and the proofs that are there meant in the platform for discussion and validation, they are very feeble and fragile tools. And what are the tools? There are innumerable theories which I want to state now. I can just give a list of few theories. One is continental disaster theory. Second is cultural disaster theory. And third thing is theory of obsoleteness. Fourth is the cryptics theory. These things are some of the theories which are meant for justification of things. What is continental disaster theory? Continents like Atlantis and Lemuria, they have been totally disastrously annihilated. So most of the treatises, if this system is perplenary and consummate, that is, it has everything. Whatever you have, what is your consummate? Number one, it is the only thing that carries everything. Number one. Number two, even if somebody can carry something, that can be the reflection of what you are carrying. So we are the container as well as the distributor. So this is known as consummate theory. I possess, I am the wholesale stockist and distributor of universal civilization and ethical status and intellectual status. This is the thing. And for that we want a lot of materials. And the materials that are available, even available materials are voluminous in treatises. What happened to